you're wanting to attract birds to your outdoor space, obviously you need a reason to have them stop by. And that exactly is why we're gonna show you how to do our woodland birdhouse. Not a lot of ingredients in this recipe, really simple for you to pull together, and it really allows you to be creative. I don't like a craft project where I exactly have to follow the rules. I like to have a little wiggle room, so this one absolutely has that. You'll need a birdhouse, you'll need some outdoor paint, paint that you can put on a terracotta surface. This is a small little saucer. We're gonna use this as the feeding station on our birdhouse. Some different types of moss, some outdoor twigs, and of course some birdseed to fill in. You'll also need to use a hot glue gun with this project. And really the kind of fun, whimsical part of this project is this old door hinge, and we'll get to that in just a moment. The first thing you wanna do though is to paint your terracotta saucer. You wanna get that painted so it can start drying. So I'm just gonna take some of my outdoor paint. Layer it on. Again, this doesn't have to be perfect. And because it's small, it doesn't take a lot of time. This is something your kids can help you do. And you can use any color that you want. I chose this moss green because we've sort of have the moss theme going. We're wanting it to look very woodsy, outdoorsy. So paint that around. I'm gonna set that down in there to finish off the edges. Make sure you don't have any bare spots. Looks pretty good. And then we'll just set that aside and let that dry, and we'll use that a little bit later as we progress with our birdhouse. So from there, we're gonna take the birdhouse. And the first thing you wanna do, I think, is to glue on this hinge. Again, you're hot gluing this. You wanna make sure that it's really secure. And I like to get this in place before I do anything else. So the one thing with this particular hinge is we're kind of doing it upside down, if you can see. If it was in a door, it would be like this. Your temptation might be to put this up on the top and have it step down. You wanna do it on the reverse. You wanna have it so that you have your design on the bottom, and then this is acting like a shelf. So position that so that you're going to be able to space it so that you'll be able to rest your saucer right on top, and then hot glue it into place. Press it down, hold it. Remember, you're putting metal here onto wood, so you really want to make sure that that's nice and secure and that's going to hold up. And if you need to, nothing wrong with even just going back if you can, and just putting a little bit more along the top. Because once that cools, that'll help to grip that as well. Once you have that done, we're gonna start working on the top, and this is where you're going to do your moss. So again, we're gonna rely on hot glue as our adhesive, and you're gonna take different types of moss and glue it onto the top of the birdhouse. I'm gonna lay this piece here, put a little bit on the back of the moss. I always like to make sure it's really secure. And then you just press that into place. Pretty simple. We'll do the other side. And it's nice because again, it doesn't have to be perfectly balanced. If one's a little bit longer and one's a little bit shorter, I think that's what's charming about it. I think if this is kind of giving that feel of something rustic out in nature, part of the perfection of it is the imperfection. So if you're a real stickler for things, loosen up. Just let it go. All right, so that's your first layer of your moss. That looks cute. We're gonna add a little texture now by adding some of these pops of this green reindeer moss, just to add in some little bits of color. Kind of almost like when you're painting and you want shading and things like that. You can just press those in. Might even put a little bit of that by the front door too. One more little bit. And Then we're gonna add some twigs. So the twigs are gonna add a completely different texture. And there's no rhyme or reason here on where you put them, but if you have some bare spots where you didn't put the moss, that's the perfect place just to nestle in some of your twigs. Hold those in place to make sure that the hot glue really grips it. And if you need to go back and add a little bit more, the beauty is you always can. So there's two little twigs on that side. I'm gonna add one more on this side for a little bit of balance. And that I can glue right on top of the moss if I want to. All right, coming together. So the next thing we're going to do, clear off all of your hot glue strings, is to actually put our saucer, which was painted and now dry, into place. You hold it up here and you want the edge here of this saucer to be right at the edge of the entrance to your birdhouse. So it lines up just right. Kind of eye it so that you can see that you have a nice flat base there, and then it kind of gives you an idea of where you want to put your glue. Press that down, hold it in place, and you're going to let that dry. So now, as you can see, you have a little area here for your seed. We've added the moss touches. As I look at it, I feel like I need a little something up in here. So let me just add a little bit more moss, just a little touch, just because we can. And then you're going to take your bird seed. Put in a little serving. And your birdhouse with bird seed is ready to go. If you decide you want to hang this outdoors, all you need to use is one of those little kind of screw-in, almost teacup kind of hooks. Very easy to do. Twist it down into the wood. I like to use twine. Loop it through. And you're ready for your wonderful birdhouse to be outside to enjoy. But don't forget, if you decide not to put any birdseed in that feeder, you have something awfully cute to use indoors too. For more projects, go to QVC.com and search YHJ.